I work with a lot of beginners here. Can you explain like what a seller disclosure is and like, you know, when you use it? Let's start with that.
Yeah. So every state is going to have their minimum requirements that you have to disclose. But on top of that, there's also known defects. That's just kind of an overarching thing. So if I'm selling you my house, I know that this house had termite problems. Mm-hmm. Now I fixed it, but I know it's had termite problems. In the state of Texas, I need to tell you that. And if I don't, you buy it, you tear at the walls, and you're like, whoa, this is a mess. And it's such a mess. There's no way. Like I can see that some of it's been repaired and all that. There's no way they didn't know that. And it cost you money. I mean, I'm not an attorney, but you could probably find an attorney to have a legal standing against me. So I have a legal obligation to tell you about known defects of the home. Has it flooded? Has anyone ran a meth lab out of it? Has anyone died inside the home? Is there a roof leak that maybe I just kind of patched up, but I know it's there? Is there a plumbing leak behind the wall that, you know, I patch up? Those kind of things. I have to tell you. Now, if I don't know it, I'm not,
fine.
Well, maybe. I mean, there are, I mean, because you can get sued for anything, but there are attorneys who have, they'll go after you for, you should have known. It's called willful ignorance. And none of this is legal advice. This is just experience and talking with attorneys, but there is what's called willful ignorance. Like if you're like, someone's trying to tell you, and you're like, no, I don't want to know that. I don't want to know that. Don't tell me because I don't have to disclose it. I mean, that doesn't absolve you of responsibility. But at the end of the day, I have to disclose, and there's state and there's federal things you have to disclose. And if you don't, you put extra risk on yourself. Why do it?
Yeah. Okay. So you have to do that no matter what, whether or not you have a license. So that's all fine. Then you mentioned disclose value. I'm actually not familiar with that term. So when you're buying it as a realtor, you have to tell them what it could be worth? How does that work?
Yeah, and this is part of the realtor. It's not necessarily having a real estate license. So the professional organization for a real estate license is called Realtors. So not having a license, that would be very confused. A real estate agent, you don't actually have to be a realtor. That's an extra step that gets you access to MLS and all that stuff. So that's part of the code of ethics that realtors have. And it's putting the client first, putting the consumer or their interests first. I just know that just because I tell you the home is worth $350,000, I mean, that doesn't really do much for you if you got to put 70 grand to get there. Like if you want to do that, man, I got some rockstar contractors, this and that, do it. I'll get it listed for you. We'll get the thing sold in a week. Might take you 8 weeks. And on top of that, like, do you have the 75 grand to do that? Do you want to do that? If you do, like, cool. But if not, and we can move forward today, $205,000 cash, like, you're all done.